and push them into well-built 8-star institutions that would bring out their skills and help them become the best that can ever be. So what we need, that's what leadership is necessarily about. You know, so you drive policy, you drive, you know, systems that can benefit the common good. Leadership is about the common good. And that's why my mentor, Dr. Myles Munroe, defined leadership in a very powerful way. He says, leadership is the ability to inspire, motivate, drive a group of people towards a particular direction via inspiration, not intimidation or manipulation.
So anybody,
it doesn't matter whether you're a housewife, it doesn't matter whether you work for a mechanic company, it doesn't matter what you do. Once you are an individual who decides to be responsible to create a vision and do things that can impact people, you are an outstanding leader.
Wow.
So people must understand that leadership starts from being ordinary to extraordinary.
So part of my concern is, I will still bring back the issue of politics in Nigeria. Part of my concern is the fact that we have started, we're almost rolling out the second tenure of this government. And by 2023, a new government will be announced. And people have been shouting, oh, the constitution has been our problem. The 1999 constitution is outdated. It should be abolished, this and that. Do you think also that the 1999 constitution is the problem? And what part of it do you think, if abolished, you know, because people are calling for a restructuring and all that, will make the next government, you know, or the future of Nigeria better?
Yeah, well, I welcome any activity that will, you know, help, you know, restructure the country. Do you get what I mean? I welcome any activity that would help, you know, in terms of, you know, moving some things from the, you know, exclusive list. Do you get what I mean? And democratizing it, those things, and giving more power to the states. You know what I mean? I welcome any of that. I also welcome anything that can bring about electoral reforms, you know, electoral reforms in a way that gives power to the citizens of Nigeria to select whosoever they want to select without any type of, in anybody trying to impose their own leadership of a few, you know, on the Nigerian people. When the people are free to vote their right, their candidate, without institutions of government being part of, you know, trying to steal away people's mandate. If we're able to get that right, and then we would now include the rise of a new set of leaders. Because if you build institutions and you don't have quality leadership to drive the institutions will collapse. If you build institutions and then you groom the next generation of leaders, it means huge investment in leadership development, in the human capital, the people that are driving in the civil service, the quality of the leadership capital is awesome, high. And those in the political system, before they are elected into offices, they are people of honor and integrity. You bring those people up. If you throw them up, and those people have vision, they have commitment for the common good, they are interested, they have compassion, because compassion is a skill that is needed in the public space. You can't be a politician without the capacity to actually inspire people in an effective way. So it is that excellence that, you know, people have in their mind to think about, you know, the position is not for myself. You know, every position is for the common good. You know, it was that type of, you know, passion that drove, you know, people like Michael Opara, you know, who was governor in the eastern part of Nigeria in those days, that he drove them to real work. And those people did some fantastic work. Even the Sadwala of Sokoto, you know, it was passion that drove them. They were thinking about their people. Do you get what I mean? So where has that, you know, concept of, you know, people gone to? I mean, celebrating people. Where has it gone to? So what we're talking about is that anytime an opportunity is given for anyone, you know, to occupy a public position, The purpose of the public position is to serve the common good. Don't, it's not for self, it's not for your family, it's for how do we utilize power, you know, to add value to human beings.
Utilizing, you know, power, yes, to add value to,
yes,
human,
that's
beings,
leadership.
Yes, but we're seeing, because of how we are in this country and what have been sold to us from the beginning, you see people you're even trying to help, you know, people just believe the lies. You know, you see a common man hailing somebody that he knows is a cheat, is a liar, is a thief. But because the person has already acquired wealth, they don't care where the person got it from. Because you have tested, contested to be a governor in Imo State. You know, talking about, yes, this, what was your experience? Because you still see people who tell you, no, I'd rather go for this person that we already,
you know,
know
so the thing is, you know, people have been deprived over time.
Mm-hmm.
You know what deprivation does to people. If you deprive people of the right to live,
mm-hmm,
the right to earn a living, so what people, you know, their mindset has been, you know, distraught, mm-hmm, in such a way that people are hungry. So when they are thinking, they think stomach infrastructure,
yeah,
and when people are thinking about stomach priority over the future of their children, that's problematic in itself. It means that society has failed over time.
Mm.
And that's why the most great, you know, important work for us to do as a people is to begin to go to the grassroots and begin to reorientate and transform the mindset of the people and begin to point to them that they have to be the ones to, you know, take themselves out of the situation that they are in. There has to be a lot of leadership education. Leadership education has to be grassroots based.
Mm-hmm.
It has to be massive. There has to be massive investment. And that's why I've said to myself, if I don't get that level of massive leadership education, I might not want to run for governor again, because I'd be wasting my time.
Absolutely.
You know, so until I get a critical mass of people who they have been taught that they must lead at a personal level. And once there's leadership at a personal level, then there's leadership at the political level, you know, where they can decide, they have the power to decide to throw out people and throw in people into position of power. That's where we must go as a people. And, you know, the knowledge is rising.
Mm.
You can see a lot of things that happen in this country over time, the NSACs,
yeah,
and all of that.
Yeah.
You know, people are beginning to get that conscious that,
absolutely,
they can do something different.
Mm-hmm.
And I want that build up for 2023. Elections in Nigeria, so that the people in this country can do what is appropriate. That you can decide to starve for a couple of days, but to take the right decision to ensure that only people who are honorable quality, people who have capacity to lead at different levels, from local government to those you send at the National Assembly Abuja or at the local assembly, state house of assemblies, there must be people who are visionary.
Mm-hmm.
There must be people who have a heart for the common good, compassion. There must be compassionate people. There must be people with a heart to serve. There must be people who are knowledgeable, and there must be people who believe in the rise of the common good. And if you have those type of people in place, in a critical mass of those people, if you have them more in the political space, then I can tell you we would have a future. Because one person cannot provide the type of leadership that we need. We need a critical mass, and I think that's where we are.
Thank you so much. We're still going to go for a break and we'll be right back. You're still on Right On with Joyce. So you were talking about, getting people to understand the concept of leadership and,
yes,
try to be good leaders themselves. How can we get to GOTNI, to the remotest places in Nigeria?
That's a very, very interesting one. In fact, we just finished Emerging Leaders Conference in Owerri for 1,000 people. So one of the things that we'd like to do is to set up GOTNI Leadership Center in Owerri.
Mm-hmm.
My commitment is that, you know, in the next couple of years, we must have penetrated every local community in Imo State,
mm-hmm,
as a case study, right? Mm-hmm. Now, we used to have a partnership with NYC, where every year we send our men all over the country to inspire those NYSC, core members, and push them into well-built eight-star institutions that would bring out their skills and help them become the best that can ever be. So what we need, that's what leadership is necessarily about. You know, so you drive policy, you drive, you know, systems that can benefit the common good. Leadership is about the common good. And that's why my mentor, Dr. Myles Munroe, defined leadership in a very powerful way. He says, leadership is the ability to inspire, motivate, drive a group of people towards a particular direction by inspiration, not intimidation or manipulation.
So anybody,
it doesn't matter whether you're a housewife, it doesn't matter whether you work for a mechanic company, it doesn't matter what you do. Once you are an individual who decides to be responsible, to create a vision and do things that can impact people, you are an outstanding leader.
Wow.
So people must understand that leadership starts from being ordinary to extraordinary.
So part of my concern is, I will still bring back the issue of politics in Nigeria. Part of my concern is the fact that we have started, we're almost rolling out the second tenure of this government. And by 2023, a new government will be announced. And people have been shouting, oh, the constitution has been our problem. The 1999 constitution is outdated. It should be abolished. This and that. Do you think also that the 1999 constitution is the problem? And what part of it do you think, if abolished, you know, because people are calling for a restructuring and all that, will make the next government, you know, or the future of Nigeria better?
Yeah, well, I welcome any activity that will, you know, help, you know, restructure the country. Do you get what I mean? I welcome any activity that would help, you know, in terms of, you know, moving some things from the, you know, exclusive list. Do you get what I mean? And democratizing it, those things, and giving more power to the states. You know what I mean? I welcome any of that. I also welcome anything that can bring about electoral reforms, you know, electoral reforms in a way that gives power to the citizens of Nigeria to select whosoever they want to select without any type of, in anybody trying to impose their own leadership of a few, you know, on the Nigerian people. When the people are free to vote their candidate without institutions of government being part of, you know, trying to steal away people's mandate. If we're able to get that right, and then we would now include the rise of a new set of leaders. Because if you build institutions and you don't have quality leadership to drive the institutions will collapse. If you build institutions and then you groom the next generation of leaders, it means huge investment in leadership development, the human capital, the people that are driving in the civil service, the quality of the leadership capital is awesome, high. And those in the political system, before they are elected into offices, they are people of honor and integrity. You bring those people up. If you throw them up, and those people have vision, they have commitment for the common good, they are interested, they have compassion, because compassion is a skill that is needed in the public space. You can't be a politician without the capacity to actually inspire people in an effective way. So it is that excellence that, you know, people have in their mind to think about, you know, the position is not for myself. You know, every position is for the common good. You know, it was that type of, you know, passion that drove, you know, people like Michael Opara, you know, who was a governor in the eastern part of Nigeria in those days, that he drove them to rework. And those people did some fantastic work. Even the Sadoala of Sokoto, you know, it was passion that drove them. They were thinking about their people. Do you get what I mean? So where has that, you know, concept of, you know, people gone to? I mean, celebrating people. Where has it gone to? So what we're talking about is that anytime an opportunity is given for anyone, you know, to occupy a public position, the purpose of the public position is to serve the common good. Don't, it's not for self, it's not for your family, it's for how do we utilize power, you know, to add value to human beings.
Utilizing, you know, power, yes, to add value to,
yes, that's
beings.
Leadership.
Yes, but we're seeing, because of how we are in this country and what have been sold to us from the beginning, you see people you're even trying to help, you know, people just believe the lies. You know, you see a common man hailing somebody that he knows is a cheat, is a liar, is a thief. But because the person has already acquired wealth, they don't care where the person got it from. Because you have tested, you have contested for to be a governor in Imo State. You know, talking about this, what was your experience? Because you still see people who will tell you, no, I'd rather go for this person that we already know.
So the thing is, you know, people have been deprived over time.
Mm-hmm.
You know what deprivation does to people. If you deprive people of the right to live,
mm-hmm.
the right to earn a living, so what people, you know, their mindset has been, you know, distraught,
mm-hmm.
in such a way that people are hungry. So when they are thinking, they think stomach infrastructure, and when people are thinking about stomach priority over the future of their children, that's problematic in itself. It means that society has failed over time.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why the most great, you know, important work for us to do as a people is to begin to go to the grassroots and begin to reorientate and transform the mindset of the people and begin to point to them that they have to be the ones to, you know, take themselves out of the situation that they are in. There has to be a lot of leadership education. Leadership education has to be grassroots based.
Mm-hmm.
It has to be massive. There has to be massive investment. And that's why I've said to myself, if I don't get that level of massive leadership education, I might not want to run for governor again, because I'll be wasting my time.
Absolutely.
You know, so until I get a critical mass of people who they have been taught that they must lead at a personal level. And once there's leadership at a personal level, then there's leadership at the political level, you know, where they can decide, they have the power to decide to throw out people and throw in people into positions of power. That's where we must go as a people. And, you know, the knowledge is rising.
Mm.
You can see a lot of things that happen in this country over time, the NSACs,
yeah.
and all of that.
Yeah.
You know, people are beginning to get that conscious that
Absolutely.
They can do something different. And I want that build up for 2023. Elections in Nigeria, so that the people in this country can do what is appropriate. That you can decide to starve for a couple of days, but to take the right decision to ensure that only people who are honorable quality, people who have capacity to lead at different levels, from local government to those you send at the National Assembly Abuja or at the local assembly, state house of assemblies, there must be people who are visionary.
Mm-hmm.
There must be people who have a heart for the common good, compassion. There must be compassionate people. There must be people with a heart to serve. There must be people who are knowledgeable, and there must be people who believe in the rise of the common good. And if you have those type of people in place, in a critical mass of those people, if you have them more in the political space, then I can tell you we would have a future, because one person cannot provide the type of leadership that we need. We need a critical mass, and I think that's where we are.
Thank you so much. We're still going to go for a break and we'll be right back. You're still on Right On with Joyce. So you were talking about, getting people to understand the concept of leadership and
yes.
try to be good leaders themselves. How can we get GOTNI to the remotest places in Nigeria?
That's a very, very interesting one. In fact, we just finished Emerging Leaders Conference in Owerri for 1,000 people. So one of the things I would like to do is to set up GOTNI Leadership Center in Owerri.
Mm-hmm.
My commitment is that, you know, in the next couple of years, we must have penetrated every local community in Imo State
mm-hmm.
as a case study, right? Mm-hmm. Now, we used to have a partnership with NYSC, where every year we send our men all over the country to inspire those NYSC, core members.